solid cylinder's moment of inertia. Please write down a thin rod. But just write rod. Here is a rod. Okay? And you need to find out moment of inertia of this rod about the axis which passes through the end and perpendicular to the rod. The axis is this axis. So how it should rotate? Like this. Or it should rotate like that. This is also that axis about which it rotates. Fine? Find out moment of inertia. The method is exactly same the way we have derived the center of mass for the rod earlier. Total length is L and total mass is M. ML. Should it be ML square? Is all the mass located at a distance of L from this line? No. Should it be less than ML square or more than ML square? Less than ML square, right? So if you get answer which is more than ML square or equal to ML square, then that is wrong. about this axis you have to find. Same mass m, total length is l. So here you are considering a small mass dm of width dx at a distance of x. So this is also integral of x square dm, no, which is x square m by l into dx. Everything remains same except the limits. What will be the limit? If you take 0 to l by 2, you cover only half the length. The mass over here will be also there, which will be at a distance, same distance, yes or no? But listen here, you are changing orientation when you go L by 2 this side and then L by 2 that side. So your limits are minus L by 2 to plus L by 2 to cover the full rod. What is the answer now? See, you will face difficulty when you have to apply integral calculus in physics. Everybody faces difficulty. It's not that somebody learns by birth. But if you face difficulty and then resist it, oh, this is not something I want to do, then you will never learn. Everybody learns from scratch, right? Huh? No, you're not able to add something properly. What is the answer? ml square by 12 is the answer. Integral will be what? X cube by 3 minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So you will have m by 3L L cube by 8 minus of minus L cube by 8. So you are going to get ML square by 12. Okay. So whatever you are deriving, you must remember this. Nobody is going to tell you that moment of inertia of rod about this axis, that this axis is this. You have to remember it when you solve problems. But anyways, when you solve a lot of problems, you tend to remember these automatically. Okay. So moment of inertia for the rod, you must remember from the end and from the center. Okay? Right? Now can you tell me moment of inertia of the rod about this axis? The axis that passes through the rod. The rod is thin. It will be zero. Moment of inertia about that axis, zero, because all the mass is at a distance of zero from the axis. Fine. Whatever you found out is about the axis that is perpendicular to the rod. How many axes passing through the center exist which are perpendicular to the rod? How many? This is the rod. How many such kind of axes exist? Infinite. You just rotate it. You get infinite axes. Are you getting it? There are infinite axes. Alright? Alright? Okay. Please write down. Hollow sphere. square at the corner. Mass M and radius R. Is the answer MR square? I am talking about this axis. Guys, should answer be less than MR square or equal to or more than MR square? Less than MR square, because some mass is closer to the axis. Okay, now I am going to tell you a way to find out moment of inertia of this without integration. Okay, so suppose this is your z axis, this is your x axis, all of you please draw this y axis. Suppose there is a small mass dm. This is dm mass. Where the mass will be? On the surface only? Mass will be on the surface, right? And let's say its coordinates are x, y and z. X, y, z. The origin is the center of the sphere. Okay? Now, let's say I want to find out moment of inertia about z axis, iz. Okay, iz for this small mass should be what? Perpendicular distance of the small mass square times dm. Yes or no? Now tell me, what is the perpendicular distance of this mass from the z axis? What is the perpendicular distance of this point having x, y, z coordinate from the z axis? Suppose this is that xyz coordinate, this is z axis, x and y. Alright, here is a point whose coordinates are xyz. Z axis is distance from the floor. This is z axis. I want a perpendicular distance from this line. So how do you find out? Root over of x square plus y square. All of you agree? Okay, so perpendicular distance of this dm from the z axis is root over x square plus y square, right? Okay, so moment of inertia of the dm mass, let's call it as di because it is for the small mass. So diz will be equal to root over x square plus y square the whole square, so x square plus y square dm, right? Any doubts here? Now there will be multiple such particles, right? So if you add up all that to find the total moment of inertia, so iz is summation of xi square plus yi square times dm. This is the moment of inertia of the entire sphere about the z axis. Any doubt? Now tell me, what should be ix? Ix will be what? Summation of yi square plus zi square times dm. Y will be
x square
plus z square times dm.
So then for the other cases, so how did we take summation? Why did we take
you can integrate here also. Summation integration are same. Okay? Listen here. I want to tell you how to get without integration also. Now, is iz, ix and iy all are equal or not? It's a sphere. Any line passing through the center is same in all aspects. Right? So, ix is equal to iy is equal to iz. So, if you add it up, you will get 3 times iz is equal to what? 2 times of summation. Please do it your own. X square plus y square plus z square times dm. Do you get this? This is what you get or not? Right? And can you tell me what is x square plus y square plus z square? What it is? Distance of the surface from the center, what it is? Radius. Radius square. Right? r square, which is a constant for whichever x, y, z you take. Getting it? So you will get 3 times of iz is equal to 2 times summation of r square dm. So r square is constant, so comes out 3 times iz is 2 r square summation of dm. What is summation of dm? Total mass. So iz is 2 mr square by 3. So moment of inertia of the hollow sphere of mass 7 radius r is 2 by 3 mr square. The axis should pass through the center. What? 3? This is r square. This is a distance of a point from the center.
Why did you equate
for these 3 i's? Yes. See, if it is a sphere, moment of inertia about any line passing through the center should be same, because this axis is no different from that axis. It's a sphere, it is three-dimensional symmetrical figure. That is why I have taken iz, ix and iy all three equal. Due to symmetry, all of this comes. Okay, now you can choose to integrate also. The way we have found out the center of mass location of a hemisphere, similar way you can follow and get the answer after integrating. That is your homework. Please write it down. The homework is to determine the moment of inertia using integration for the hollow sphere. Integration is easier or this is easier? But this is tricky actually. Integration is straightforward. When you learn it, it becomes simpler. Okay, so the homework is to find out moment of inertia of the hollow sphere using integration. How you integrate? You assume a ring below. Here you assume a ring like this, the way we have done it for hemisphere. And you take angle theta like this, and this is d theta. You remember? We got the radius of this ring as r sine theta, and the width of the ring is r d theta. Okay, so you can do mass per unit area into the area of the ring and try to do it your own. Okay. Alright, next is solid sphere. This is the last one. Write down solid sphere. See, in your in the school, the syllabus or if you see, they will directly tell you to remember these values of moment of inertia. They will not ask you to derive it, integrating and all that. Okay? But these methods, you must understand how to do it, because JEE likes to test you on the basics. They will create a hypothetical scenario where mass changes with length and find out moment of inertia of the rod now. So if you know how to exactly solve it, you will apply the same method to solve there as well. But if you remember the moment of inertia without knowing how it is coming, you will not be able to solve many such kind of questions. Solid sphere, banana sphere. You will assume that solid sphere is made up of this concept. This concept, if you do it like this. Best is to assume it is made up of hollow spheres. Hollow sphere will expand its radius and cover the entire solid sphere. Got it? Okay. Suppose it is made up of hollow spheres. This is r and the width is dr. Can you find out integral of di? By the way, what is di? Over here, what is di? Let's say mass of this hollow hemisphere is dm. So di is what? Is it r square dm? No. It's a hollow sphere. So you have to integrate 2 by 3 r square dm. This you have to integrate. It's a hollow sphere, right? For hollow sphere, moment of inertia is 2 by 3 mr square. And the mass is dm now. Now try doing this your own. This is the last one. Get it yourself. The method is exactly same which we did to find the center of mass of the solid hemisphere. Just refer it back, do it yourself. How you find dm is same. How you find dm is same. And it is same not only for this chapter, it will be same for class 12 also when you go and talk about charge and current and everything else. Same way you have to follow. Better to learn now only. Capital R is the radius of the big sphere. Now the mass is distributed on surface or the length? It is distributed on volume. It's a solid sphere, right? So mass per unit volume you have to make. Mass per unit volume into volume of the hollow spheres mass. Okay, some silly error you have done. Do what I'm asked to pay. Regular shape objects. Alright? But what is the issue? The issue is the moment of inertia. The issue is that moment of inertia of different axis is different for the same object. Okay? So I can't just keep on integrating for the same object for different axes and find the moment of inertia. So there has to be a way to find out moment of inertia of other axis knowing moment of inertia of one of the axes. So there should be a relation between the two axes. Fine? For that, we are going to learn two theorems which will relate moment of inertia of one axis with respect to the moment of inertia of other axis. Alright? Very straightforward, simple theorems. Alright? Please write down. I am going to done this topic, otherwise just 5 minutes topic, I should not leave it to the next class, okay? Let me finish this off. Please write down parallel action theorem. And it is there in KVPY, by the way. Electro side mein KVPY. Listen. Sit straight. Why? Turn and just go. Okay, parallel axis theorem. So, draw a rigid body like this. This is a, need not be a regular shape. Fine? This is a rigid body. Okay? This is an axis that passes through the center of mass. This is an axis that passes through the center of mass. And moment of inertia above the center of mass is ICM, let us say. Okay? There is another axis. Achha, by the way, the axis need not pass through the object. So this, above this axis also the entire object can rotate. Entire object will rotate like this. Okay? So about this axis, let's say this is the another axis. I, both axes are parallel to each other. If I write down ICM and I are parallel to each other and the distance between them is D. Written? Okay. So according to parallel axis theorem, I will be equal to ICM plus total mass of the rigid body into D square. Okay, this is parallel axis theorem, and what does it mean? Can I say that ICM is the least? Yeah. This will always be a positive number. So moment of inertia about any other axis is always ICM plus a positive number. So moment of inertia or inertia against the rotation is least about the axis that passes through the center of mass. And how many such axes are possible? How many center of mass axes possible?
No, infinite.
Infinite. Infinite. Okay? And there can be different moment of inertia about different center of mass axes. Fine? But one thing is sure, if you are finding the least moment of inertia of all the axes possible, it must pass through the center of mass. Okay? There is a small proof of this. Let's assume this is your z-axis, x, and let's say this is y. Done? Okay. Let's assume that there is a mass here whose coordinates are x, y, z. Let's say mass is small mi, xi, yi, zi. Its perpendicular distance from the z is what? Root of x square plus y square. So moment of inertia z axis, which is also ICM, is summation of, write down, xi square plus yi square. Yes or no? Perpendicular distance is root over x square plus y square. Mi r square is mi into x square. x square plus y a square. Alright? Okay? This is the parallel axis to the z axis. This axis is parallel to the z axis. So moment of inertia about that axis, what do you think this will be? Summation of mi into what will be its perpendicular distance from this axis? The axis is displaced along the x. What d? Perpendicular distance, its x coordinate will be reduced by d, yes or no? So its x coordinate relative to this line will be xi minus d. Getting it? If d is exactly equal to x, the x coordinate for this line will become 0. Are you getting it? So it will be summation of xi minus d whole square plus yi square. It is displaced only along the x axis, and you can create such scenario. You can rotate your coordinate axis in such a way that it got displaced only along the x axis. Fine. Now expand this summation of mi xi square plus yi square this is what you get. Okay. X square plus yi square plus d square summation of mi minus 2d summation of mi xi. Did you get this? Did you understand how this comes? Understood? I have just expanded and taken summation inside. D is constant, comes out of summation here and there both. Getting it? What is this? ICM? So I is equal to ICM plus what is this? D square into summation of all the masses is total mass. So M into D square. Now what is this? Summation of mi xi divided by summation of mi. This is what? X center of mass. Do you remember that? And what is x center of mass over there? Zero. Center of mass is at the origin. So this is equal to zero. So summation of mi xi becomes zero. So this term goes. This is a proof of parallel axis theorem. Perpendicular axis theorem proof is just two steps. It is next theorem, the last topic for today. Just two steps. Have you understood this? Yes. Copy it down, please. Done? You should copy it down while I am telling. Okay. What is the restriction in parallel axis theorem? One axis must pass through the center of mass. Are you getting it? You can't use it between the two axes and none of them passes through center of mass. The last topic for today focus perpendicular axis theorem. This is valid only for planar objects. What are the planar objects? Tell me. Planar object. A disc, a square plate, a ring. All of the objects which entirely in a single plane are called the planar objects. Okay? So according to this theorem, first draw a planar object. This is a planar object. This can also be irregular shape. X, Y, Z. Moment of inertia about z axis will be the sum of the moment of inertia about x and y. Okay, there is no restriction that it should pass through center of mass. And please write down z axis. Z axis must be perpendicular to the plane of the object. Iz is perpendicular to the plane. Ix and Iy can be in the plane, but Iz must be perpendicular to the plane. And there is a reason why they are called Ix, Iy and Iz. The reason is they are all mutually perpendicular to each other. Getting it? Okay, a quick proof of that. Let's say this is coordinate xi, yi. For mass mi, what is its perpendicular distance from the z axis?
Zero.
Zero. This is z axis and this is the point xi comma yi. So root over x square plus y square is the perpendicular distance. No, demanding number, right? Huh? Perpendicular distance of a point from the z axis is always under root x square plus y square. We have been using it till now. It doesn't matter whether it is a plane or solid figure. Okay? So Iz is, please write down, summation of mi. Okay. अरे ऐसे लग रहा है हम टॉर्चरी मिल चुके हैं अभी जब as soon as this topic get over all of you will die नंबर कैसे What is happening? Focus. You should happy that you are knowing parallax theorem property and theorem. जाके बताना अपने दोस्तों को जाके listen listen. Today, just one step away from the proof. Okay? This is. Stop talking. What is this? Tell me. What is xi? Perpendicular distance of the point from which axis is xi? Y axis? Summation of mi xi square is I y. And what is the yi coordinate from which axis is perpendicular distance? X axis. So this is your iy and that is your ix. Okay. So this is the proof of perpendicular axis theorem. Please write down oblique axis theorem. Guys, this theorem is used quite often if Ix is equal to Iy due to symmetry. For example, if it is this moment of inertia about any diameter should be same. So Ix is equal to Iy for a disk. And Iz is mr square by 2 anyways, you know it. So Ix plus Iy become 2 times Ix is mr square by 2. So about the diameter moment of inertia is mr square by 4. Because this is mr square by 2 and these are 2 equal. So 2 times of this is equal to mr square by 2. This is equal to mr square by 4. We can do one problem. Kitna time hua hai? What is the time?
3:45.
So you go home and proudly tell your friend, listen, I have attended 4 hours.